So, as we are discussing a unit in physical geography, that is biogeography. Okay, in biogeography, we have discussed biospheres. Then we have discussed ecosystem. Then we have discussed ecology. Okay, and then we started our discussion of biomes. Okay. Last class, we saw that there are eight major type of biomes. Okay, and in the last class we studied one of them, that is tropical evergreen forest or tropical rainforest biome. Okay, so today we will study two more biomes, that is tropical deciduous tropical deciduous and tropical grassland. Okay, so the next class, which will be on Thursday next week, okay, will be last class on biomes. Okay, I will try to discuss 3-4 biomes in that class. Okay, and in case it is not completed in the next class, I will provide you the word file, okay, where you can study all the other biomes, or I will tell you the sources from where you can study all other biomes, okay, because the content these biomes have, okay, we will need to give 7-8 classes to these biomes, and we don't have that much classes, okay. So today we will cover two more, so that will be 3, and if we can cover 3 in the next class, it will be 6, and I will provide you content for the rest of the two biomes. You can complete that on your own. Okay, so just 1 minute before we start, okay, what is biome? Biome is nothing but biotic part of ecosystem. Ecosystem has two parts, biome and habitat. Okay, in biome we study okay, the living organism and their relation with their environment, and in habitat we study about the soil or soil and topography of that particular region. Okay, so we are studying here the biome, and in the last class we came to a conclusion that there are 8 major type of biomes in this world. Okay, and these biomes are tropical rainforest, tropical grassland, deciduous forest, deserts, Mediterranean forest, temperate grassland, taiga and tundra. Okay, so basically these biomes are categorized based on vegetation. Okay, if I can have a clean page, I can make you understand few concepts. Yes. Okay. So these biomes are categorized depending on the vegetation. Okay. Vegetation can be of 3 types. Tree, grassland, and desert. Okay, and what is the relation with their climatic factor? Okay, only this rainfall. Okay, amount of rainfall in areas where we have rainfall between 100 centimeter to 200 centimeter, there we find forests or trees. Okay, in the area where we find rainfall between 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter, there we find grassland, and in area where the rainfall is less than 50 centimeter, we find desert. Okay, and then take care, and then okay, right, forest, then डिपेंडिंग ऑन द लोकेशन फॉरेस्ट कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप ट्रॉपिकल फॉरेस्ट विच एग्जिस्ट ठीक है. सो फॉरेस्ट कैन ऑन इट्स लोकेशन फॉरेस्ट कैन बी ऑफ टू और थ्री टाइप. यू कैन से ट्रॉपिकल temperate taiga and tundra. At the same time tropical forest can be of two type. theek hai, one type is evergreen in the region where rainfall is all around the year, and then theek hai, deciduous where rainfall occurs or there is one dry season. That means there is one season in which there is no rainfall. ठीक है. So depending on that, tropical the forest can be tropical evergreen forest and tropical deciduous forest. At the same time, temperate evergreen forest and deciduous evergreen forest. Temperate deciduous forest. ठीक है. Then we have taiga and tundra. When we talk about the grassland, we can have two type of grassland, tropical, which exists in the tropics, between the tropics, and then temperate, which exists in the middle latitude, okay, then desert. This is how, okay, depending on vegetation, different regions of the world has been divided into the 8 different biomes, okay. And why depending on the natural vegetation? Because, ठीक है, because animal community depends on the natural vegetation. Okay, the characteristic of animal community in some region depends on the characteristic of plant community in that region. ठीक है, this is how world have been divided into different biomes. ठीक है. ठीक है. ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट दैट मीन्स ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन, ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड, ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस, डेजर्ट, मेडिटेरेनियन, टेम्परेट ग्रासलैंड, टैगा एंड टुंड्रा. ठीक है. दीज आर द 8 मेजर बायोम्स. ठीक है. वी स्टडीड दिस ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट इन द लास्ट क्लास. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन ऑन ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड देन ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट. ठीक है. So, ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड बायोम इज ऑल्सो नोन एज सवाना बायोम. ठीक है. सो नाउ यू हैव स्टडीड और यू हैव हर्ड सवाना ट्वाइस. सवाना इज ऑल्सो अ क्लाइमेट रीजन. सवाना इज ऑल्सो अ नेचुरल वेजिटेशन रीजन. ठीक है. एंड सवाना इज ऑल्सो अ बायोम. वाई? बिकॉज इट हैज some special type of plants, and depending on that there are special type of animals which are found only in this biome. Every biome has some different type of plants and animals, and depending on the similarity of plants and animals, boundary of a biome is decided. ठीक है. जितने एरिया में same type के plant और animal मिलेंगे वो एक biome होगा. ठीक है. And it will differ from the other biome depending on dissimilarity or uniqueness of the biome. ठीक है. So savanna biome extend in both the hemisphere between 10 degree to 20 degree latitude. ठीक है. Its expansion is in llanos of Colombia and Venezuela. I hope you guys remember this. Composed of South Central Brazil, Guinea and Paraguay, hilly areas of Central America, savanna grasslands of Central and East Africa. ठीक है. So grasslands of Africa are known as savanna grasslands. ठीक है. And as these grasslands are the largest grassland in the world, this type of biome is named as savanna biome, or the climate region is named as savanna climate region, or the natural vegetation is named as savanna natural vegetation. ठीक है?
So it is also known for elephant grass.
Sorry?
So it is also known for elephant grass.
Yes, yes, elephant grass. I'm coming to that. ठीक है? And another region is North Australia and some areas of India. ठीक है? This point or this concept should be remembered. ठीक है? This has been asked. Savanna of India is not the original and natural vegetation cover. Rather, it has developed due to human interference with original forest cover, resulting into the development of widespread man-induced grassland. ठीक है? So what happened? ठीक है? What happened in India? The savanna, okay? In India, here, ठीक है? There was no savanna grassland. Okay? Savanna grassland was not present in India. ठीक है? But with the time, man removed or cleared the deciduous forests. ठीक है? Deciduous forests of this region, and due to removal of deciduous forests, ठीक है? This region was converted into the savanna region. ठीक है? So this question has been asked in UPSC. ठीक है? They asked whether the savanna region or savanna climate region in India or savanna vegetation in India is original. So no, it's not original. It is made by, or it has been converted into the savanna due to the interference of mankind. ठीक है? So this you should remember. Savanna of India is not the original and natural vegetation. ठीक है? So if a question asks that, ठीक है? If a question has two sentence statement that savanna grasslands are found in the peninsular plateaus of India, and the second statement is that savanna is natural vegetation of peninsular India. So only first statement is correct and second statement is wrong, because savanna vegetation or savanna grassland is not original or natural vegetation of India. ठीक है? It has been brought or it has been changed by the interference of the people living there. ठीक है? So these are the region of savanna grassland. This is Llanos. This is Campos. This is savanna. ठीक है? This is Indian savanna and this is Australian grasslands. ठीक है भाई? Can anybody name me few temperate grasslands? Can anybody tell me some temperate grasslands?
Steppes.
Yes, steppes.
ED.
Prairies.
Prairies. Veld. Bushes of Australia, and then steppes, prairies, veld, and bushes. So
down.
Australia. Yeah, down of Australia. ठीक है? So this is Australian bush. ठीक है? So these are the savanna grassland of the world. Now let's see the climate here. ठीक है? We noticed in the last class that in any biome, we first study the location, then climate, then plants, and then animals. ठीक है? So this is the order which we will follow in these two biomes also. ठीक है? Savanna climate is characterized by distinct wet and dry seasons. ठीक? Mean high temperature throughout the, okay? Mean high temperature throughout the year and abundant insolation. ठीक है? So in savanna biome, there will be at least one dry season. ठीक है? And they will receive high insolation throughout the year. ठीक है? Temperature will be high in this area. We will discuss this later. Mean annual rainfall ranges between 250 millimeter to 500 millimeter. That means 25 centimeter to 50 centimeter. ठीक है? On the desert fringe of savanna and 130 centimeter to 200 centimeter on its border with the equatorial climate. Now try to understand this. ठीक है? ठीक? Here we have equatorial, oh, sorry. Or we can say here we have tropical rainforest biome. ठीक है, equatorial world is also right. ठीक, biome. And here we have desert biome. ठीक है, so in the near vicinity of tropical rainforest biome, ठीक है, rainfall is around 130 centimeter to 200 centimeter, while in these areas you can say rainfall is between 70 centimeter to 100 centimeter. ठीक है, so mean annual rainfall is between mean annual rainfall is between 25 to 50 centimeter. ठीक है, in desert fringes and 130 centimeter to 200 centimeter in border with equatorial climate. ठीक है, there is much pronounced variation in spatial distribution of mean annual rainfall in the different parts of savanna biome of the world because of distance from the equator and nature of the topographic features. ठीक है, so there is nothing in it. ठीक है, what does it want to say? ठीक है, as I told you, there is a huge spatial variation in annual rainfall. Here it is just maybe 25 centimeter, while here it is near 170, here it is 25. ठीक है, तो huge variation in rainfall. So the cause of the variation is one is distance from the equator. As you move away from the equator, you get nearer to the subtropical high pressure zone, and hence amount of rainfall decreases. And second cause is topography. ठीक है, topography. ठीक है, these words are situated near these Andes. So ठीक है, in this region rainfall is more, while in this region rainfall is less. Okay, because whenever there is a orographic rain, rainfall will be more near the mountains, and as we move away from the mountains, rainfall will decrease. So even in the llanos, here rainfall is more and here rainfall is less. So there is a great spatial distribution or spatial difference between in the rainfall of different regions of the savanna biome. ठीक है, and that difference depends on two things: distance from the equator and nature of topographic feature. ठीक है, temperature does not fall below 20 degree Celsius in any month of the year. ठीक है, so here we left it mean high temperature throughout the year, so temperature never fall below 20 degree Celsius. And ठीक है, there are three seasons: cold, dry, as it is in our country, or you can say in northern plains, southern coastal states don't experience the winters. ठीक है, so cold, dry season, warm, dry season, and warm, wet season. ठीक है, we have a tendency to say that summer, winter, and rainy season. ठीक है, जाड़ा, गर्मी, बरसात, but this is not the rainy season. The correct definition is of this is warm, wet season. ठीक है, so we don't receive rainfall in winter, we receive rainfall only in summers. Just give me one second. ठीक है, सो दिस इज So we don't have a rainy season, but instead of that, the correct narration is we have warm wet season. Okay, rainfall occurs in our country during winters. Okay, so this is the three seasons. In cold dry season, temperature of the day ranges between 26 to 32. In warm dry season, it is 32 to 38. And in warm wet season, okay, it falls below 32 degrees Celsius. Okay, so these are the climate characteristics of savanna biome. Now let's move into the vegetation. Normally, savanna biomes refers to the vegetation community of tropical area, which is characterized by dominance of ground cover by partially xeromorphic herbaceous plants, upper stratum of scattered tree, and middle layer of sparse shrubs. Okay, that means there are three layers. Okay, I will explain it in the next few slides. Okay. The savanna vegetation community has developed layer structure wherein there is three distinct layers. Okay, we had five layers in tropical rainforest biome. In savanna, we have three layers. Okay, ground layer is dominated by various type of grasses and herbaceous plants. Okay, the grasses are the most dominant vegetative member of savanna biome. That means large area is covered by with the grasses. Okay, remember this sentence, it has been asked. Okay, grasses in savanna biome are generally coarse, stiff, and hard. Okay, and of course perennials having the height of 80 centimeter, but very long grasses reach up to 35 centimeter in height. ठीक है चलो सो देर आर पीपल इन आर क्लास विच हैव रेड बायोलॉजी ओके सो वी ईट वीट एंड राइस सो वट आर दिस वीट एंड राइस आर दे ट्रीज और प्लांट्स और ग्रास वट आर दिस वीट एंड राइस
ग्रास आई थिंक
यस ग्रेट इट इज ग्रास ठीक है So we eat some fruit or a flower of the grass, okay? So don't get confused or don't get motivated when somebody tell you that Maharana Pratap have eaten bread of grass. So we all eat grass, okay? This question has been asked once in state PSC, okay? Wheat is tree, grass, and some options were there. So wheat and rice both are the grasses, okay? So we eat grass. ठीक सो दैट इज वाई द लार्ज रीजन ऑफ इंडिया इज अंडर सवाना वेजिटेशन ठीक है बिकॉज वीट एंड राइस आर द ट्रॉपिकल और यू कैन से राइस इज अ ट्रॉपिकल ट्रॉपिकल ग्रास ओके एंड वी हैव इन द सदर्न इंडिया ओके देर इज लार्ज स्केल कल्टिवेशन ऑफ राइस सो दैट इज वाई वी से दैट द पेनिनसुलर इंडिया इज अंडर सवाना वेजिटेशन ठीक है अर्लियर That region has tropical deciduous forest, but those forests have been cleared out for cultivation of rice. Okay, so the grasses are the most dominant vegetative member of savanna biome. Okay, and the grasses here are coarse, stiff, and hard. Okay, and they don't have much nutrition value. ठीक है ग्रासेस फाउंड इन टेम्परेट ग्रासलैंड हैव हाई न्यूट्रिशियस वैल्यू बट ग्रासेस फाउंड इन ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड और सवाना ग्रासलैंड ठीक है डोंट हैव हाई न्यूट्रिशन वैल्यू ठीक द एलिफेंट ग्रास ठीक है द अफ्रीकन एलिफेंट ग्रास अटेन्स अ इनॉर्मस हाइट ऑफ 5 meter द लीफ ऑफ दिस ग्रासेस आर ऑलमोस्ट फ्लैट विच आर शेड ड्यूरिंग द ड्राई सीजन Okay, but they are regenerated during the wet season. Okay, so this is the elephant grass. Okay, large elephant grass. Okay, it may be pointed out that not all grounds are continuously covered by grasses. Okay, Rather, there are frequent open patches which are devoid of grasses. ठीक है. The root system of savanna grasses consists of lateral dense network of fine branches which penetrate up to depth of 2.5 meter in soil cover. Why do they have dense network and deep penetration? Because this area suffers, okay, or this area has a scarcity of water. Okay. And in dry season, upper soil moisture is removed. So soil have to get, or the roots have to get water from the deep layers or deep underground water resources or reservoirs, and that is why their roots have depth of 2.5 meter. Okay. This I can't remember. If you can, it's good, or you can leave it. The important genera of savanna grasses are, okay, Hyphrenia, which is known as elephant grass, Panicum, Panicetum, okay, Andropogon, and African species Emperita cylindrica. Okay, these are biological name. Okay, it can be asked, but if you can't remember, then okay, you cannot help it, so just leave it. Okay, middle layer consists of shrubs and very stunted woody plants. Okay, stunted, I explained it. Okay, shrubs and stunted. So lower layer is of grass, second layer is of stunted plants. Okay, let's see that layer. Okay, then top or canopy layer is formed by trees of various sorts. Okay, so it is not, you know, it is not true that savanna grasslands are devoid of trees. No, this again was asked in UPSC in one of the statement. So it has trees. Okay, the savanna trees have developed various unique characteristic to cope up with the dry condition of the biome. Okay, so basically, okay, they have developed two unique characteristic. One is xeromorphic. What are the xeromorphic condition of characteristics? Okay, in this xeromorphic adaptation, okay, leaves of the trees become very small. Okay, okay, there are few species of trees which have developed such mechanism with help of them to reduce evapotranspiration from their leaves during warm dry season. So this sentence is basically saying that this trees of savanna vegetation have developed few unique characteristic, okay, to reduce the evapotranspiration through leaves during dry season. Okay, so now let's see these two characteristics. Okay, a few species of trees which have developed such mechanism which help them to reduce evapotranspiration from their leaves during warm dry season and enable them to remain green during dry season. Okay, so this is xeromorphic condition in which leaves of the trees become very small, okay, and it reduces the evapotranspiration through leaves. Okay, this is known as xeromorphic adaptation. Okay, leaves have become very small, okay, so that there will be no evapotranspiration through the leaves. And few examples are cactus, okay, or nagfani, okay, or kheer. Okay, if you will see cactus, okay, the leaves are so small that there will be no evapotranspiration. Then, so there are basically two mechanisms in one, leaves are small, and in other, trees shed leaves during dry season. Okay, on the other hand, there are such trees tree species which cannot withstand dry condition and therefore they shed their leaves and bear the characteristic of deciduous forest. Okay, so there are two mechanisms which can be adopted by trees in the savanna biome. Either they reduce the size of means with biotic succession with in thousands of years through biotic succession. Okay, leaves have become small so that there will be less evapotranspiration, or other characteristic is that they can shed their leaves. Okay, so this can be asked in which form? Okay, in tropical deciduous biome, okay, trees shed their leaf during the dry season. Okay, then they can ask that in tropical grassland biome, in dry season, trees adopt only xeromorphic adaptations. Okay, so it is not true. They don't adapt only xeromorphic adaptation, but they also shed their leaves. Okay, so these type of question has been asked, and you will find these type of question in the test series also. Okay, the root system of savanna trees have also developed according to the environmental condition, as they are very large, which can penetrate into the soil and ground up to the depth of 5 to 20 meters, so that they can obtain water from groundwater. They can obtain groundwater even during the dry season. Okay. Now I will confuse you. Okay. The smaller plants and many herbaceous plants have a special kind of root system characterized by root tubers and swelling so that they may preserve water which may be used by the plant during dry season. Okay, so they have root which can swell, which can store water for months. Okay, and when they store water, they swell, and during the dry season, okay, these roots are during the dry season, a tree get the water from these swelled roots. Okay, so these are known as root tubers. Can anybody tell me one example of root tubers? Here, root tubers. The
dahlia.
Dahlia. Okay, I don't know what is dahlia. Basically, I am unable to recall the name, but okay, there is a ingredient in our daily diet that is mooli.
Mooli, shakarkand, ye sab, matlab sweet potato, ye sab bhi tuber ka hi
hai. All are these, okay? All you can say all the plants in which we eat the root are generally the root tuber plants, okay? In which excess water is stored in the roots, okay? And okay, and that is how a small plant can survive
but in the dry condition. But both are different here, sir.
Yeah, I'm explaining that.
Because root tuber में आपने जो बोला वो edible part है जिसको कि हम लोग खाते हैं, root ही है but खाते हैं उसको. But यहाँ पे जो root tuber की बात हो रही है वो basically water preservation के लिए हो रही है ताकि plant survive कर सके.
So that was what I'm saying ना कि गर्मियों में कुछ roots हो हैं जिनमें हम ये कहते हैं कि they have a high content of water and we eat them. So these roots are basically root tubers, right?
Yeah.
ठीक है ना, मतलब all the roots which we eat are not the root tubers, but in the dry season few roots we eat because they have high water content, and these are generally the root tubers. ठीक है so there is a difference. ठीक है, okay, now let's see. Because the roots of these plants seldom reach the depth of 20 centimeter in the soil, and the coarse soil up to this depth become dry during the dry season. Okay. On one hand, okay, I told you that roots of trees in this biome reaches up to the depth of 5 meter to 20 meter. Okay. Then I'm telling you that okay, roots in these areas or these biomes cannot reach more than ठीक है, 2 meters, 20 centimeters, ठीक है. सो बेसिकली दीज रूट्स विच रीच अप टू 5 to 20 meters आर द रूट्स ऑफ लार्ज ट्रीज विच फॉर्म द टॉप लेयर, ठीक है. दे अडॉप्ट दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, ओके, देयर रूट हैव अडॉप्ट दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ पेनिट्रेटिंग डीप इन टू द अर्थ लेयर्स सो दैट इट कैन हैव वॉटर, ठीक है. स्मॉल प्लांट्स इन मिडिल लेयर, ठीक है, हैव अडॉप्टेड अनदर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, ओके, दे ओके, एज द प्लांट इज अ स्मॉल रूट कैन नॉट पेनिट्रेट डीप इन टू द अर्थ, सो they have developed the characteristic or developed their adaptation that their roots are characterized to store water, theek hai. So these are very small things, okay, remember these things, okay. When in UPSC the second prelims, in prelims when second paper was objective or of subject, theek hai, up to 2008 or 11, ठीक है, there was two paper in prelims, ठीक है, one was GS, another was subject. So these type of questions were frequent, very frequently asked in this, ठीक है, this objective test of optional subject, ठीक है. So large plants in the savanna biomes have large roots, while ठीक है, small plants, stunted plants have, ठीक है, have this root tubers or roots which can store water. Yes, someone of you has unmuted yourself. Please mute yourself. There is a disturbance. ठीक है भाई. So this is the characteristic of roots. ठीक है, roots. And there is a characteristic of leaves also. ठीक है, so vegetation and savanna biomes have adapted few adaptation. ठीक है, so leaves have adapted two adaptation. Xeromorphic adaptation, or they shed their leaves, and tubes have also adopted few adaptations. One is, ठीक है, okay, deep roots, and second is tuber roots or root tubers. ठीक है, in UPSC, in state PSC, you will find this question very often. ठीक है. So because of the root of these plants seldom reach, okay, this is done. The savanna biome is characterized by monotony of tree species as there are very few species per unit area, okay. In tropical rainforest we saw that there is huge diversity of trees, okay, while in these tropical grassland biome or savanna biome, okay, diversity of trees are not very huge, okay. So depending on the proportion of trees and grasses, these savanna biomes can be divided into four type of savanna: woodland savanna, tree savanna, shrub savanna, and grass savanna. Okay. So in this four categories, okay, it is in increasing order of tree cover. Okay. In woodland savanna, maximum number of trees are there. In tree savanna, number of trees reduced. In shrub savanna, number of trees reduced. And in grass savanna, there are only grass, no trees are no trees are available. Okay, so depending on proportion of trees and grassland, savannas can further be divided into four type of grasslands: woodland savanna, tree savanna, shrub savanna, and grass savanna. Okay, so this is the vegetation. Now let's see about the animals. Okay. The African savanna accounts for the largest number of the greatest variety of grazing vertebrates and mammals in the world. Okay. So here we have a concept. ठीक दैट अफ्रीकन सवाना अकाउंट्स फॉर लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ ग्रेटेस्ट वैरायटी ऑफ ग्रेजिंग वर्टिब्रेट मैमल्स ठीक है बट हाईएस्ट बायोडाइवर्सिटी ऑफ एनिमल इज स्टिल इन ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट ठीक है बट इफ द क्वेश्चन आस्क अबाउट द हाईएस्ट बायोडाइवर्सिटी ऑफ ग्रेजिंग और ग्रेजिंग वर्टिब्रेट एनिमल मैमल्स देन दिस इज ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड बायोम और सवाना बायोम ठीक है द ऑस्ट्रेलियन सवाना इज डोमिनेटेड बाय मार्सुपियल्स व्हाट आर द मार्सुपियल्स बेसिकली कैंगरू ठीक है एंड अदर्स आर देयर टिपिकल मैमल्स ऑफ साउथ अमेरिकन एंड ऑस्ट्रेलियन ओरिजिन व्हिच हैव पाउच इन देयर बॉडीज टू कीप एंड फीड देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग्स ठीक है तो उनके जो छोटे छोटे बच्चे होते हैं उनको पाउच में रख के चलते हैं ठीक है वन इम्पॉर्टेंट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस मार्सुपियल्स आर कैंगरूज ठीक है यू कैन सी और यू कैन सर्च द इमेजेस ऑफ दिस कैंगरूज ठीक है दे हैव अ पाउच इन विच they can put their child and they can also put the food okay and then they move like this theek hai then the large grazing mammals of south american savanna includes deer and guanaco theek hai besides toucans parrots nightjars kingfisher dove finches parakeets woodpeckers are also found in large number in south american savannas theek hai so if you can remember the name of the birds in these areas theek hai you can remember these are toucans parrots nightjars kingfisher doves finches parakeets woodpeckers okay if you can't then again you can but we can can't do anything theek hai so the large animals include deer and guanaco and also the australian savanna have marsupials theek hai these are the important fact the relatively less denser cover of vegetation in savanna biome provides maximum mobility to the animals and the savanna grassland have been responsible for the origin and evolution of the great number of large animals or large mammals like elephant giraffe zebra ganda hippopotamus and antelopes and birds such as coosers bustard game bird ostrich and emu theek hai so even the size of bird is very large in these savanna biome okay why because there is large space and plant concentration or density of the plant do not hinder the movement of these mammals so they have achieved or they have adapted or they have evolved okay into the larger bodies okay yesterday I explained you that savanna elephant is larger than the these Amazon elephants and I have also explained you the reason behind it theek hai so these are the animals in spite of large and great variety of animals of invertebrate and vertebrates theek hai there is no competition theek hai this one thing is again conceptual and important okay although there are huge variety of mammals but there is no competition for food among the animals in savanna biome ठीक है बिकॉज ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट एनिमल ऑफ दिस बायोम हैव डेवलप्ड टिपिकल फीडिंग हैबिट्स एंड मैकेनिज्म अकॉर्डिंग टू द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ द वेजिटेशन ठीक है सो व्हाट हैपेंड बेसिकली ठीक है इन दिस सवाना बायोम देर आर थ्री लेयर्स ठीक है ग्रासेस मीडियम प्लांट एंड लार्ज प्लांट ठीक है सो द एनिमल्स हैव ऑल्सो बीन डिवाइडेड इन टू द थ्री कैटेगरीज ठीक है टॉल एनिमल्स विच कैन ईट फ्रॉम द ट्री ओके मीडियम साइज एनिमल विच कैन ईट फ्रॉम दिस स्मॉल स्टेंटेड प्लांट्स एंड स्मॉलर एनिमल्स और दिस ग्रेजिंग एनिमल्स विच ईट ग्रास ठीक है सो देयर इज अ एग्जांपल ऑफ इट जिराफ यूजेस टॉप लेयर ऑफ ट्रीज एंड श्रब थ्रू इज एक्सेप्शनली लॉन्ग नेक ठीक है जेब्रा लीव्स ऑन द लीव्स ऑफ द श्रब एंड द हेड ऑफ द टॉल ग्रासेस Wild beast graze the grasses of medium height, whereas the gazelles depends on the short grasses. ठीक है तो छोटी ग्रास को हिरन खाता है, बड़ी ग्रास को गजेल खाते हैं, ठीक है, मीडियम साइज प्लांट को ज़ेब्रा खाता है, और जो बड़े प्लांट हैं उनको जिराफ खाता है. तो दिस इज हाउ, ऑल्दो देयर इज अ वैरायटी एंड बायोडाइवर्सिटी ऑफ ग्रेजिंग मैमल्स इन दिस एरिया, और यू कैन से हर्बीवोरस इन दिस एरिया, ठीक है, बट दे हैव डेवलप्ड अ स्पेशल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक और स्पेशल फूड हैबिट, ओके, थ्रू विच दे कैन सर्वाइव, ओके, दे कैन सर्वाइव और दे कैन हैव फूड अवेलेबिलिटी. ठीक है, इट अपीयर्स दैट देयर इज अ क्लोज करेस्पोंडेंस बिटवीन वर्टिकल स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन ऑफ वेजिटेशन कम्युनिटी एंड फीडिंग हैबिट्स ऑफ द एनिमल ऑफ सवाना रीजन. ठीक है, दीज आर इम्पॉर्टेंट स्मॉल सेंटेंसेज, कंसेप्चुअल सेंटेंसेज विच कैन बी आस्क्ड एनीवेयर. ठीक है, एंड दिस हैज बीन आस्क्ड ऑलमोस्ट ईच एंड एवरी ईयर. समटाइम दे आर टॉक अबाउट स्टेबी, समटाइम दे आस्क अबाउट द रेन फॉरेस्ट, समथिंग दे आस्क अबाउट, ठीक है, अबाउट दिस सवाना ग्रास लैंड. ठीक है, एंड यू हैव एन एडवांटेज ओवर द स्टूडेंट विच हैव अदर ऑप्शनल्स. ठीक है, बिकॉज दे डोंट स्टडी बायोम्स इन दिस डिटेल. ठीक है, सो ट्राई टू यूज दैट एडवांटेज. ठीक है, सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द ट्रॉपिकल ग्रास लैंड बायोम और सवाना बायोम. ठीक है, डू एनी वन हैव एनी डाउट? Yeah, I've tried to explain the things which needed explanation, okay, but we move to the sites very quickly because I have to discuss one more biome. Okay, so if anyone have any doubt, we can quickly discuss or I can move to the next biome. Yes, no, stop,
no, go. Sir, go ahead.
Great. Take care. So the next biome is tropical deciduous forest biome. Take care. We also call them monsoon biome. ठीक है, there are three major area of tropical deciduous forest biome. One is neotropics, mainly in West Indies. Then Indo-Malaysian zone, mainly in South and Southeast Asia, except equatorial evergreen forest, and then in Eastern Africa and Northern Australia. Do we have map? No. Let's mark them. ठीक है, सो मॉनसून बायोम्स वी फाइंड इन वेस्ट इंडीज, ठीक है, इंडो मलयन पेनिनसुला, ठीक है, दैट मींस साउथ साउथ एंड साउथ ईस्ट एशिया. ठीक है, यू ऑल्सो फाइंड इट इन ईस्ट वेस्टर्न ऑस्ट्रेलिया, नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न ऑस्ट्रेलिया. ठीक है, सो दीज थ्री रीजन्स विच गो थ्रू द मॉनसून क्लाइमेट एंड दीज थ्री रीजन्स आर अंडर दिस ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट बायो. ठीक है, एंड देन वी हैव सम ईस्टर्न अफ्रीका, सॉरी फॉर. ठीक है, वी हैव सीन दैट मडगास्कर रीजन, this Madagascar and Somalian coast also experiences the monsoon climate. Okay, so now let's see the monsoon biome climate. Okay, besides these major areas, some discontinuous localities of tropical deciduous forest biome are also found in South Africa, southern Brazil, southeastern USA, Formosa, that means Taiwan, and southern China and Japan. Yeah, some areas of these countries experience the monsoon climate. Okay. Tropical deciduous forest biome is characterized by two distinct seasons, moist season and dry season. Okay. Average temperature of warm, dry summer season ranges between 27 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Celsius, but the maximum temperature ranges from 38 to 48. Okay, this is basically the climatic characteristic of North Indian plains. Warm, humid summer season records average temperature between 20 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. This was the dry summer, okay, May, June. This is the warm, humid summer. दैट मीन्स, ठीक है, दैट मीन्स जून जुलाई, ठीक है. द टेम्परेचर ड्यूरिंग द ड्राई विंटर सीजन रेंजेस बिटवीन 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस. ऑन एन एवरेज द मीन एनुअल रेनफॉल इज अराउंड 150 सेंटीमीटर. But there are much variation in temporal and spatial distribution of rainfall. So what is the difference between tropical rainforest, okay, and tropical deciduous forest? Okay, here, even here rainfall is in the range of 150 centimeter, but here rainfall occurs throughout the year. Okay. All 12 months, but in tropical deciduous forest, okay, average rainfall is same 150 centimeter, but here maximum rainfall occurs in summer months and winter months are dry. Okay, on an average mean annual rainfall in this region is 150 centimeter, but there are much variation in temporal and spatial distribution of rainfall. Okay. Now let's see the vegetation. The number of plant species is less in tropical deciduous forest biome than the tropical evergreen forest biome. Okay, as plant species are less, okay, or you can say as this rainfall is less, okay, so the species will be less. Since the density of plant is lower in this biome than the rainforest biome, and hence there is a comparatively less competition among the plants to get the sunlight. ठीक है, अभी try to understand this. ठीक, I told you that. Abhijit, please mute yourself. ठीक है, I told you.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you tell me the class means the which subject you are top discuss means the which subject, because I have received.
Yeah, go on. It is Barnali Ghosh.
Yeah,
it's Barnali. This is class of geography optional. Are you here for the CSAT class?
Yeah, sir, actually I have received one mail that is about polity, because in I don't have the link. They are not providing link. So in my yesterday's CSAT class link, I enter through this link actually.
Who has conducted that class? Whose class is it, of quality? Who is the educator in that class?
I don't. Okay, sir. I'll just go there. Okay, sir.
Okay. This class will end in 10 minutes. Maybe that class is in succession with this class. So you can either you can try with another link, or you can try the same link after 10 minutes. Okay. She has already gone. Great. So, okay, I told you that in middle layers of rainforest biome, okay, size of leaves are very large. ठीक है, एंड व्हाट वाज़ द रीजन बिहाइंड इट? कैन एनीबडी टेल मी? ठीक है, रेन फॉरेस्ट बायोम के मिडिल लेयर में प्लांट्स जो हैं उनकी पत्तियां बहुत बड़ी होती हैं. आई एक्सप्लेन द रीजन
टू अटेन मोर सनलाइट.
यस, मोर सनलाइट. व्हाई? ओके, व्हाई? Because there are large trees, okay. So let's discuss this also, okay. Why do we have tall trees in rainforest biome? Because there is a fight for sunlight or competition for sunlight, and in this competition, okay, few trees increases their height and they became tall, and few trees adopted another adaptation and they increase the size of their leaves. Okay, so that they can receive more sunlight. Okay, so So in tropical rainforest biome, size of tree leaves are large or broad. ठीक है, why? To have sunlight. But ठीक है, but in tropical deciduous forest, we don't have, ठीक है, we don't have any competition among the plants for getting sunlight. ठीक है, but still leaves are broad in this biome. Why? ठीक है, ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट बायोम में लीव्स का साइज बड़ा है, ब्रॉड लीव्स हैं. व्हाई? टू हैव मोर सनलाइट, बिकॉज देयर इज अ कंपटीशन फॉर सनलाइट इन ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट बायोम. ठीक है, बिकॉज देयर इज हाई डेंसिटी ऑफ प्लांट्स. लेकिन ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट में कोई ऐसा कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं है, बट स्टिल ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट हैव broad leaf plants. Why there is a broad leaf, or why this sort of adaptation? Can anybody explain? Use little bit of brain. Why?
To store water.
Yes, great. To receive or to soak more water. ठीक है, टू एब्सॉर्ब मोर वाटर. ठीक है, सो इन ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट बायोम साइज ऑफ लीव्स आर लार्ज टू एब्सॉर्ब मोर सनलाइट, व्हाइल इन ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट साइज ऑफ लीव्स आर लार्ज और ब्रॉड टू एब्सॉर्ब मोर वाटर. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द अगेन small conceptual facts which can be asked in UPSC. ठीक है, the height of the most trees ranges between 12 to 30 meter. ठीक है, there are four stratas or layers in the vertical structure. ठीक है, tropical rainforest has 5. ठीक है, grassland has 3 and tropical deciduous forest has 4. Okay, the uppermost and second strata layer consist of trees. Third stratum is formed by the shrubs, where the last and fourth stratum is represent herbaceous plants. Okay, so there are four layers. There are four layers. Two layers are of trees. One layer is of shrub, and the lowest layer is of herbaceous plants. Okay. Most of the trees are deciduous, but the shrubs of the third stratum are again evergreen. ठीक है, द ट्रीज आर कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय थिक गर्थ ऑफ स्टेम, थिक रफ एंड कोर्स बार्क एंड लार्ज हाइड्रोमॉर्फिक लीव्स और स्मॉल हार्ड एंड ज़ेरोमॉर्फिक लीव्स. ठीक है, देयर आर टू थिंग्स, यू हैव टू स्टोर वाटर. हाउ कैन यू स्टोर वाटर और हाउ कैन यू हैव वाटर? आइदर स्टोर मोर वाटर और यूज लेस वाटर. टू स्टोर मोर वाटर वी हैव हाइड्रोमॉर्फिक ब्रॉड लीव्स. ठीक है, इफ यू हैव लिमिटेड वाटर, ठीक है, इफ यू हैव लिमिटेड वाटर, देयर आर ओनली टू वेज टू स्टोर वाटर और मैनेज वाटर, आइदर स्टोर मोर वाटर और यूज लेस वाटर. ठीक है, तो दिस थिंग इज डन बाय द दिस मोर स्टोरेज और मोर एब्जॉर्प्शन आर डन बाय द हाइड्रोमॉर्फिक लीव्स, हाइड्रोमॉर्फिक ब्रॉड लीव्स एंड लेस वाटर इज यूज by these xeromorphic small and hard leaves. ठीक है, the large hydromorphic leaves enable the trees to trap more and more rainfall during the wet season, but these large leaves are shed in the dry periods to conserve moisture. ठीक है, these hydromorphic plants have to shed their leaves. ठीक है, बिकॉज दे कैन नॉट सर्वाइव विद दैट लार्ज लीव्स एंड देर विल बी मोर इवेपोट्रांसपिरेशन, सो दे शेड देयर लीव ड्यूरिंग द ड्राई सीजन. व्हाइल विद द ज़ेरोमॉर्फिक लीव्स दे डोंट हैव टू शेड देयर लीव्स, ओके, बिकॉज इवेपोट्रांसपिरेशन इज ऑलरेडी वेरी लेस. देर आर न्यूमरस क्लाइंबर्स, मेनली लानास एंड एपिफाइट्स, बट देयर नंबर्स आर फार लेस एज कंपेयर टू द ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट, ठीक है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ठीक है. टील एंड साल, ठीक है, टीक एंड साल, ठीक है, ठीक है, आर द टू मेजर मेजर ट्रीज ऑफ दिस ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट बायोम और मॉनसून फॉरेस्ट बायोम. बैम्बू इज अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट मेंबर ऑफ इंडियन डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट. तो साल, टीक एंड बैम्बू, ठीक है, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इट बिकॉज इन यूपीएससी वंस दे आस्क्ड अबाउट द चंदन, दे आस्क्ड अबाउट देयर, सॉरी, दे चंदन बेसिकली इज नोन एज व्हाट इज चंदन कॉल्ड इन इंग्लिश?
अरोमा,
और समथिंग वाज रेड रोज, रेड सैंडलवुड, आई थिंक रेड सैंडलवुड दे आस्क अबाउट, ठीक है. सो दीज आर द स्मॉल थिंग विच यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, बट दिस वी विल स्टडी इन इंडियन नेचुरल वेजिटेशन, ठीक है, ठीक है. सो डोंट गेट डिसहार्टेंड, दिस वी विल स्टडी इन डेप्थ इन इंडियन नेचुरल वेजिटेशन व्हेन वी विल कंप्लीट कवर इंडियन ज्योग्राफी, ठीक है. बट फॉर द जनरल नॉलेज, साल, टीक एंड बैम्बू आर द मेन ट्रीज ऑफ दिस ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट, ठीक है. ठीक, seasonal character of the monsoon deciduous forest has been responsible for the seasonal regime in breeding, reproduction and migration, theek hai. So migration is a characteristic of tropical deciduous forest biome. During the dry season, animals move towards the tropical rainforest, and then during the wet season they return to the tropical deciduous forest. Okay, the animals of the tropical and subtropical dry deciduous forest biome range from very small animals to very large bodied animals like elephant, horse, hippopotamus, gander, rhino, lion, forest buffalo, together with a large population of bird and several species. Take this is one sentence to remember. This biome represents the largest number of domesticated mammals because of the development of the agriculture. ठीक है, इसी बायोम में सबसे ज्यादा एग्रीकल्चर का डेवलपमेंट हुआ है, इसीलिए मोस्ट ऑफ द डोमेस्टिकेटेड मैमल्स वी फाइंड इन दिस बायोम, ठीक है. सो दिस इज द ट्रॉपिकल डिसीडियस फॉरेस्ट बायोम और मॉनसून बायोम, ठीक है. एज दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी मच फैक्चुअल, ठीक है, ऑल्दो इट हैज सम कंसेप्ट. So what I will do in the next class, I will try to complete it by discussing 2-3 biome and then giving 2-3 biomes in assignment. ठीक है, do anyone have any doubt in this savanna biome or monsoon biome?
No sir.
So what is the question? Compare the vegetative characteristics of savanna biome and monsoon biome. Another question in this can be discuss the biological adaptation adapted by plants and animals in savanna biome. ठीक है, these two are the question for the day. Okay. Now I will end this class and we will meet on Thursday, and there we will try to complete the biomes, and we will, after completing the biomes, we will move to biotic succession. ठीक है guys, sir, any, yes
sir, if tropical deciduous forest, the The leaves are vast or huge.
Broad, yes.
Yes, sir, broad. So for storing water, so it destroys the strong power of the leaves. Now leaves will be loose from the tree because heavy water storing.
The leaves store water for the 8 months in which are not very dry. Theek hai? So for 8 months, they you know, there will be rainfall only in three months. Okay. Mm-hmm. During that 3 months, they will store water for next 8 months. Okay? And when the water is exhausted because of the huge lean period, dry period, they shed their leaves. Okay? Okay. If you remember, okay, when they shed leaf, they don't shed leaf during the summer. They shed leaf before summer. Okay? Patjad jo hai, wo garmi se pehle aata hai. ठीक है, why? Because it is adaptation. ऐसा नहीं कि पानी नहीं है तो पत्तियां मर के गिर रही हैं. They have adapted it that before the dry summer, hot summer season, they have to shed their leaves. ठीक है, though the water which is stored in July, you can say July and August, or you can say June, July and August are used for September, October, November, December, and January and February. And at the end of the February, they start to shed their leaves. ठीक है,
ओके सर,
बिकॉज़ ड्यू टू द ब्रॉड लीव्स दे कैन नॉट अफोर्ड ओके द लार्ज इवैपोट्रांसपिरेशन. ठीक है, व्हाट विल हैपन इफ दैट सच लार्ज इवैपोट्रांसपिरेशन अकर्स, होल ट्री विल डाई. ठीक है, इफ ट्रीज इफ लीव्स आर शेड, वाटर विल बी रिटेन्ड इन द बार्क एंड द स्टेम एंड दे विल लीव फॉर द नेक्स्ट 4 months एंड देन अगेन in rainy season, water will be available and there will be new green leaves. ठीक है?
Yes.
Okay, guys. Any other doubt? No. Okay, great. So now I am ending this class. We will meet on Thursday and there we will discuss biomes, and after that we will move on to the biotic successions. Okay, guys. Thank you for your time. We will meet on Thursday.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.